Hey, look at me. I'm Nicol Bolas. I'm behind everything. I'm involved in everything. You will never stop seeing me.
I am so bored of Nicol Bolas.
Greetings, hatchlings. I am here to talk about a problem with Magic the Gathering that is exemplified by Nicol Bolas and the Gatewatch. I call it Bolas boredom. Oh my lord. Magic the Gathering has gotten very, very stilted and lazy and repetitive. And on top of that, it feels like there are no stakes in terms of the storyline. We keep seeing the same characters over and over and over. Nicol Bolas has been so overused, just even in recent times. He's responsible for everything happening on Amonkhet. Oh, and then look, we're going to go to Ixalan. You got to deal with Bolas? Well, we don't see him directly, but guess what? His influence is still felt. He's always going to be behind things. Oh, Bolas wants the Immortal Sun. Oh, Bolas did this. Bolas did that. Oh, look, Vivian Reed is from a plane that Bolas destroyed, so she's connected to Bolas. Oh, look, in the current Ravnica block, a bunch of guildmasters are guildmasters now because of Bolas. Oh, look, Liliana of the Vale has gone ahead and over time freed herself from the curse of the four demons, which was actually a pretty cool storyline. For those of you who don't know, in very broad strokes, Liliana lost her immortality when all the planeswalkers did. She couldn't handle it, so she made a pact with four demons to regain her youth and some semblance of her power, but it also bound her to those demons. So she went out and she got herself the Chain Veil, that crazy artifact, and was slowly but surely wiping out those demons, the four demons that had her enslaved, essentially. And what happens when she kills the fourth demon? Bolas shows up and goes, oh, guess what? It was all my plan, and now I own you, and you gotta serve me. Oh, gotcha. Gotcha! It's just like anytime anything interesting is happening, even slightly, oh, nope, we've got to jam Bolas in there. Bolas needs to be involved somehow. Did you think Tezzeret had been destroyed? Nope, Bolas is $6 million manning him. He's putting them back together. Woo! Whoop-de-doo, Bolas! I don't know if this is just bothering me more right now because I'm under the weather. I am not feeling good today. But overall, this is just a genuine problem that I have with Magic the Gathering. It's no-stakes Magic on top of repetitiveness. I mean, look at Amonkhet, for example. We get to see the Gatewatch yet again, and that's tiresome all in itself, just seeing the Gatewatch over and over. And even when they were like, we hear you, we're gonna dial it back on the Gatewatch, they didn't really. They just went, oh, look, we brought part of the Gatewatch here. Is that good for you? Like, why can't we have a brand new plane of existence where we don't have anything connected to what we already know? Why does there always have to be tendrils of all this other stuff connected in? This is Magic the Gathering with an infinite number of planes of existence that should theoretically have a bunch of different sources of evil out there in different places causing problems. But we just keep getting spoon-fed the same garbage over and over and over. And this laziness extends into a number of things. Like, we're going back to Ravnica, but this time it's different. It's autumn. Woo! Look at the autumnal leaves. Whoop-de-doo! So when you have Amonkhet, where you've got the Gatewatch and you've got Bolas, to get back to my point, you've got a situation where it's like, okay, you've got Bolas, who's apparently like about 20,000 years old, right? He's like 20,000 years old, something like that. A massively powerful planeswalker. He has sculpted defeat cards for each of these planeswalkers. That's why there was one for all the Gatewatch members who are on Amonkhet. Nissa's defeat, Chandra's defeat, Gideon's defeat. Like, he's made personalized spells to defeat them, and yet somehow he doesn't defeat them. It's like Inspector Gadget and Dr. Claw, and Bolas is just Dr. Claw going, I'll get you next time, Gatewatch, next time, and he just keeps being brought back over and over and over. And like, imagine every video was just me holding this up. This is Magic now. Hey, look, it's Bolas again. Hey, look, it's Bolas again. Hey, did somebody squeeze the toothpaste too hard in the middle? It was Bolas. Does your toilet paper roll not refilled and it's left there empty? Well, guess what? It's Bolas. Bolas is making me hiccup right now. Stop it, Bolas. Why do you have to be responsible for everything? I am the ultimate evil. Guys, they even crammed Bolas into the tutorial for Magic Arena, okay? And it was so infuriating. You're telling me that the most powerful evil planeswalker has got time to teach people? Oh yeah, I'm part of the tutorial. And the way that he responded, at one point you play a really garbage spell. I played a spell that costs 1 white mana and 4 colors, and it makes 3/3/3/1/1 flying creatures that you can use for blocking, right? I played it, and they had him in the game go, huh? Like, this is the most powerful planeswalker around, pretty much. Been around for 20,000 years. The ultimate evil. Huh? You played a really terrible magic spell that made 3/1/1s? I've never seen such power. You've defeated me! Bleh! It is so stupid how much they have to cram Bolas into everything. And they're talking now about how, oh, you know what, in this iteration right now, what's going on, we're going to have the final culmination of the battle between Bolas and the Gatewatch, and Bolas will finally be defeated. How did Bolas not manage to kill any of the Gatewatch? How has he not managed to wipe out any of the Gatewatch? These new planeswalkers who are inexperienced that he can craft defeat specifically to beat. How did you not beat any of them, you loser? You absolute loser. Just, I am this looming presence, and I can come up with incredibly diabolical plans, like basically subverting the entire religion of the plane of Amonkhet, taking their gods, reworking them to my vision, wiping out all the adults on the planet. How does Bolas have such evil plans and still feel so bland and vanilla and repetitive? Look at me. Everybody who's been replaced as a guildmaster was replaced because of me somehow. Couldn't come up with something else at all. Like, and they've been laying this groundwork for years. When they originally created Kaya, it was with the intention of having Bolas make her lead the Orzhov. Like, they've just... It's so repetitive and overdone and frustrating, and there's no real stakes. Because do you think for a second, if Bolas gets defeated, that they're not going to bring him back? They couldn't help themselves. They put Nicol Bolas even into the Dominaria set. We're like, oh, we're doing all cards. Oh, you know what? Just throw Bolas in there too. We'll put all the Elder Dragons in there, but it's really just so we can get Bolas in again. Bolas, Bolas, Bolas. Bored. I am bored ass of Bolas. He is so tiresome. He's not compelling. He's not interesting. He's overused. And a bunch of people are like, I like Bolas. That's because you have no imagination, or because you're so new to magic that you have no concept of what it used to be like. We had characters like Urza. Urza was insane. Urza got in a war of power with his own brother, and his brother ended up being subverted by the Phyrexians and turned into like a part man, part machine. And Urza felt responsible for the death of his brother, and he was driven by this insane need for revenge. And he was essentially like a mad god. Sometimes it was really hard to be on Urza's side, but it made him compelling because he had actual flaws. None of the characters anymore have any flaws. It's like Wizards of the Coast genuinely wanted to have their own like Avengers League or something like that. So they created the Gatewatch, and like, we'll just keep bringing them back. And honestly, the Gatewatch are just like this cardboard Bolas that I'm holding. They're two-dimensional. There's no depth to them. That's it. And Bolas is the same way. Bolas used to be more interesting, but they're just like, oh no, Bolas is attached to everything. And yet he's so incompetent. He's the major evil. And yet he's so incompetent that he never nets a win up on the board. You never chuck one up to Bolas. He's always still gotta lose. You can have recurring villains, don't get me wrong, but we need stakes. There's no stakes. You put Bolas against the Gatewatch, and what happens? Oh, look, everybody's fine because we gotta keep using him. We gotta keep bringing the same characters back. So little variety. And it's so dull to me, my friends. I want something new. I want to be wowed. Hey, look, this is like, it kind of looks like I've got like a necklace made of Bolas, or I'm wearing an outfit leading down to my sumptuous Bolases. Ooh, you're good for something after all, Bolas. This is going to be my new outfit. I like this. But yeah, honestly, there's no stakes left. Bolas is so boring and tired, and I don't believe for a second that if he gets destroyed that they're not gonna bring him back.
There's no way we're not going to be dealing with Bolas over and over and over. And you know this because Wizards of the Coast is so keen to reuse things that they went back to Ravnica and they thought that telling us it was autumn would be a big selling point. Genuinely, just, wow, look, some trees will have orange leaves on them. In a friggin' plane that's mostly cityscape. Wow, great. It's not even like the world was all forests and it was this massive change. Oh, look, in autumn, all these changes happen and it fundamentally changes the nature of the plane. It's like, nope, but you can see somebody with a pumpkin spice latte in the background just having a sip. It's so tired and lazy and low effort and no stakes. And that's how I feel about all this jazz. Now, I'm going to end it off here because otherwise I'm just going to keep repeating myself about this. You can let me know what you guys think about it. I'll be back tomorrow with another video because I make a video every day, baby. So you will see me tomorrow with my sumptuous... Oh, there we go. Now this is my chest. Here we go. Let's go for that sex appeal. Oh, do you like me now, boys? Huh? We need more women in magic, so here I am. Call me Zer Hatcher. I'm going to Zer it up. I'm gender neutral. Whoop-de-doo. All right, so let's go ahead and check in with the hatchlings.
And together,
we are
the Hatchlings!
Last thing to do is to roll the golden scroll. The people who have my back through channel memberships or through Patreon. Thanks for supporting my channel. It means a lot to me, especially on the days where I'm not feeling so great. It's awesome to have you guys having my back. When I'm bored with magic or I'm feeling sick or any of these other things, I can just look at your lovely name scrolling by and feel better. Oh, thank you. Thank you for supporting me with your beautiful money. It is far more interesting than Bolas, and it can result in steaks, the kind of steaks I can eat. All right, thanks for being here. That's all for now. See you tomorrow.
Hail to the king, baby.